What up YouTube, my name is Jack Truong, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to download Fortnite on PC. So let's get right into the video. Alright guys, we're so close to 11k. If we can hit it, that'd be amazing. If you would like to be part of the J Truong family, subscribe and turn on that post notification. Alright, and don't forget we have the merch. 10k subs here if you guys want to grab one. Links is in the description. Thank you for your guys' support. Appreciate it. Let's get back into the video. Alright, so the best way for you to learn how to download Fortnite on PC is for me to do it myself. I already installed Fortnite, the game, out of my computer, so I can do it with you guys step by step. I don't remember everything by heart, so we're gonna learn it together. So I thought that would be the best way. So, alright, so you go on to Google or wherever search browser you're gonna use. I'm gonna type in Fortnite download. Bam. All right, usually it's gonna be the first link. This www.epicsgames.com/fortnite/en-us/download. You click on that and basically it's gonna show you, say thank you for downloading. And look at that, it's already downloading for me on the bottom left right there. I'll show you guys right there, see? Sorry on the bottom left. We're gonna wait that install. Once it's done, we're just gonna click on it. Fast internet. Alright, I wanna download it on my terabyte, cause that's where it's the most memory. So I'm just gonna make a new folder and leave it for Fortnite. Hit OK. Install. Hit yes. It should be that hard to download, but I'm taking guys step by step. The current time for me to downloading this is, I think right now is season 10, right? And right now is Tuesday, August 6th. Hopefully I can finish this and upload it today. If not, I'll probably upload it Wednesday, August 7th. But hopefully we can get this video down. Yes, it's installing. All right, so once it's installed, basically if you wanna log in, you just log into your Gmail account. And that's pretty much how you download Fortnite. All right, I'll just log in anyways. So show you guys that this is not fake or whatever. All right, I just log in. My email is already saved. Alright, now this is, I think this is the Epic Launcher page, so I feel like I can leave that, alright. Yep, I'm here, I signed in, and I'm just gonna get on Fortnite so you get this view. I think you have to install it, alright. So I just installed the game launcher, the Epic Launcher. Now I need to install the game, so I'm gonna install in my Fortnite tab. I guess this is gonna be under Fortnite, right? It should be. I just made that folder. So I'm looking for Fortnite. Click on that, select folder. That's good. Install. Any Facebook friends? I got no friends. So, nope. Oh, look at that. I got some friends. But you can see that. I got no friends, guys. You guys want to be my friend? Add me. My Epic's name is right here. Code JTF. Alright. Let's see. It should be installing, I believe. Yeah, it's installing. If you hover around the game icon, it shows up right here. But let's just say you have Fortnite and you have another game from Epic's game, right? It will shows up on the right side as well. I remember I had Overcooked as well. It's a free game, my notes will download it. You know, but once that install, I'm gonna stop the recording, then I'll show you guys once I get into the game. Alright. So the game is about to be almost done installing. It's at 93% right now, so I'm just gonna wait it out. But like, I'm gonna launch the game so you guys can see that I download the game. The Fortnite game is about to be finished installed, and you guys get to see the graphics of this amazing game, you know. Anyways, while we wait, if you guys wanna know when I upload more content on this channel, just follow me on Twitter and join my Discord server, right? All the links are just in the description. Hopefully you guys are joining so you guys know when I upload, stream, or have any updates on the channel. All right, thank you for listening. Thank you for being part of today's video. I appreciate that. If you guys are watching it just because you guys are supporting me, what do you guys think of Fortnite Season 10? If you guys are new, you get excited for this Season 10 about all the new Battle Pass, what do you guys think? What's your opinion? And this installation takes me pretty long, alright? I thought it'd be done 100% after I'm done talking. That didn't happen. Okay, so what I was thinking is, like, since maybe some people might not have a better understanding, like, what I'm saying, it might help someone else explaining how to download Fortnite as well. So I'm gonna, after I'm done with like launching this game, I'm gonna show you guys another video of someone else downloading Fortnite PC as well. Alright, so the Epic launcher just finally finished installing Fortnite, so I'm gonna launch it so you guys can see its beautiful glory, right? And I'm not sure if the other clip got cut, but after this game's launched, I'll show you guys another video of someone else downloading Fortnite PC, and maybe that person explained that better than I can. So you guys have two versions of how to download Fortnite PC in one video. Alright, so let's do that. Oh, look at that. That reminds me of the Black Knight from Season 2. Overall, Battle Pass this season looks like better than most of the season. Like, all the skin wise, most of them look pretty good. Like, overall. Not just one skin, but overall. It's pretty good skin. I like the middle one. I like everybody on the right. I like all of them. Yeah, I like all of them. Except the, I don't know, the one with the llama head. I don't know my, that one. It's, I don't know, I feel like the people with big heads got a bigger hitbox. I could be wrong. I'm always wrong. I don't know. But this game is about to be done downloading, so you guys can see its glory. I wonder if it's gonna show me the Season 10 again. If it is, I'm just gonna skip it. Alright, yeah, Battle Royale. So basically, everybody's here either playing Battle Royale or Creative. If you have Save the World, you can have that. But Battle Royale and Creative are free. Save the World is not. You have to buy that game. So just FYI, just letting you guys know. Yep. And basically, if you guys want to play, you just get in here, click your game mode. Usually people play solos, duos, squads, or team rumble. If you're just alone, just hit accept on solo, hit play, bam, then you get into a game. All right. Anyway, if you guys would like to support me in the Fortnite item shop, just go to the item shop, go to Supporter Creator on the bottom right here, type in my code, JTF, hit accept. And you're supporting me, man. Like, thank you for watching this video. And I will show you guys the second video right now.
In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to download and install Fortnite on your Windows computer. So this is a free-to-play game, and I have received a couple requests to make a video like this. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. So we're going to start by opening up a web browser. Doesn't matter which one, but I'm gonna open up Google Chrome for this tutorial, and I'm gonna just type into Google Chrome. I want to get over to google.com, So into Google, you want to type in Fortnite download, and then you want to hit enter. One of the best matches should be for a domain that says download slash Epic Games. You want to open that up. Now you want to select the correct download here, so whether you're on Windows or Mac, and then once you've selected that, the download will begin, so please be patient. And once it's done downloading, we just can left click on it once to open up the file here. We can minimize that of our web browser. If you receive a security notification, just left click on run. Make sure it's a verified publisher, which it showed as Epic Games. So at this point, just left click on the install button at the bottom of this prompt here. It'll begin the process. If you receive a user account control window, left click on yes. If you receive any firewall notifications, allow access for this application. So just left click on accept. If you receive another user account control window, left click on yes. I would recommend if you get a notification for Net Framework 3.5 or any version up here that you do download and install the feature, but for time's sake, I'm just going to skip the installation here. And otherwise, once you're done doing that, you should be able to open up the application without too much of a hassle. So there you go guys, at this point you just been sign in or create an account, and that's pretty much it. So I do hope this brief tutorial was able to help you guys out, and as always thank you for watching, and I look